He joins us. Nice to see you, sir.
Thank you.
Before we get to the substance of the bill, let me ask you a little bit about the U.S. Senate. Senator Harry Reid calling essentially you and Senator Cruz anarchists, fanatics, and also even accused you of promoting a Thelma and Louise-style tactic.
Yeah, I didn't know that's what we were doing. I thought what we were doing was standing on the side of the American people, standing on the side of the House of Representatives and the leadership of Speaker John Boehner, who last week bravely decided to stand with the American people and say, let's keep the government funded, but let's protect the American people from Obamacare, a law that's going to make health care more expensive and going to harm a lot of people.
All right, so you're getting sort of a rough reception from the Democratic side of the aisle. I'm curious, are things a little chilly among your Republicans there?
Well, you know, we don't always agree all the time on every single vote, and sometimes we disagree. But I think as Republicans, we do stand behind the idea that we need to stop Obamacare. We need to fight it. We need to stop it any way we can, even though some of us might have different ideas about how best to get there.
Well, it seems that some Republicans believe that you're not going to stop it in the U.S. Senate, and that they think that perhaps you and Senator Cruz and maybe even Senator Rand Paul, if he's going to join with you, are sort of out. You're the party of three on this.
You know, just a few weeks ago, people were saying that even within the House of Representatives. They were saying, you know, there's no point in fighting for a continuing resolution that funds Obamacare, funds government, but defunds Obamacare. And we proved them wrong. The American people spoke out. The House, to its credit, stayed with the American people. The House, to its credit, decided to back up the American people and say, yeah, we're going to do everything we can to protect you from this law. And now it's the Senate's turn. It's our job now to move that forward and to stand behind what the House did and not let Harry Reid gut what the House of Representatives passed last week.
So how do you do that? How do you prevent Senator Harry Reid from essentially stripping out the defunding part of the House bill and sending it right back to the House, which is strictly the continuing resolution to be voted on? How do you stop him from taking out the defunding part?
We need to tell him in very clear terms. There are a couple of ways he can handle this. Number one, he can bring this bill up, the House passed continuing resolution, and let us vote for it up or down as is. Number two, he can bring it up and say, we're going to allow amendments. We'll allow Democrats and Republicans to introduce amendments. We will debate those. We'll discuss them. We'll vote on them. Either one of those is just fine. What's not fine is if he wants to say, I want my cake and eat it too. I want to have one amendment and one amendment only. And that one amendment will be to strip out the defunding language, to gut what the House did in support of the American people. We can't let him have that.
All right, well, that's behind door number three. And he is the Senate Majority Leader, and he can pick what's behind door number three. In terms of door number two or door number one, which are the two options that you can live with, do you have even your Republican brethren who may not agree with you, are they willing to push, for instance, to have open amendments to this bill?
Yeah, I don't know any of my Republican colleagues who would oppose either door number one or door number two. I can't speak for them, but I'm pretty confident that we would all be comfortable with either door number one or door number two. What I'm saying ought to be off limits is door number three. If he pulls door number three, we ought to, as Republicans, oppose that. We ought to oppose him with everything we've got, with anything that's going to make it easier for him to undo what the House of Representatives did.
If given the opportunity, are you willing to filibuster, do you plan on filibustering any aspect of this?
I'm willing to oppose any procedural motion.
Does that mean filibuster?
Some people would call it that. The word filibuster carries a lot of different connotations in the United States.
Well, let me give you the one that a lot of people think, where you just stand up and keep talking until someone finally cries uncle.
That's a possibility. It's not always a possibility, given the procedural framework in which we find ourselves, given whether or not there is a floor agreement governing time. But another definition of filibuster includes voting no on what's called a cloture vote. And that is the mechanism by which we could fight Harry Reid on door number three, to vote no on what's called a cloture vote, cloture on the bill. Some people might say that that would be voting against the bill, and they've got it wrong. What we would be voting against in that context is Harry Reid trying, through a manipulation of the Senate rules, to undo what the House of Representatives did. We can't let him do that. We've got to oppose him.
Apparently, on Sunday, Chris Wallace here on Fox News Sunday said that he'd received talking points against Senator Cruz and that he'd gotten them. He didn't name who his sources were. Then Governor Sarah Palin came out and said that, you know, name names. I mean, who is it that's talking within the Republican Party against Senator Cruz? Where do you fall on this? Would you like to see the names so you know who's doing this?
I would be very curious. I would love to know who those names are. I found that very disturbing. I found it very surprising. And sure, I would love to know who those names are.
Is it, everything's gotten so hostile up there in the Senate and Republican Party that, where it doesn't surprise you that people might be sending talking points against one of you within your own party?
Greta, most things in Washington don't surprise me anymore. That one did. That one does, and we've got to get to the bottom of it.
Do you talk to your leadership about that at all? What's going on with your, is Senator McConnell sort of, bringing you all sort of into a sort of room and sort of slapping you all around, saying get along and figure it out and at least work together as a party?
We're going to have a meeting tomorrow, and I have a feeling this might come up.
Do you think you'll get that then?
Yes.
Anyway, well, good luck, and we'll be, of course, watching to see what happens. When do you think the vote's going to be, by the way?
Well, I think we're going to have a vote on Wednesday. Where exactly it goes from there will depend in part on what Harry Reid pushes. But again, if what Harry Reid's going to try to do is gut the House bill, if what he's going to try to do is take this out, not let us have any amendments, but put in only his amendment that would strip the defunding language, then I think we've got to oppose it.
And then it goes back over to the House, and then what?
We keep fighting, and the House does something. The House helps us. We help the House. But we've got to stand behind the House on this one in order to show the American people we're standing with them. We're going to do everything we can to protect them from Obamacare.
Senator, nice to see you. Thank you, sir.